Thank you. Again and again it comes. A time of recollection, the season of remembrance, empty vessels of hope fill up again. Forgotten treasures or dreams reclaim their place. Long lost memories come trooping back to me. This is my season of remembrance, my time of recollection. Into the challenge of my anguish, I throw the strength of all my hope. I match the darts of my despair with the treasures of my dreams. Upon the current of my heart, I float the burdens of the years. I challenge the mind of death with my love of life. Such to me is the time of recollection, the season of remembrance.
Come, God is calling. Amid seasonal pressures and anticipations, God's Spirit envelops us in a story of accepting without knowing, of believing without answers. May we too abandon our expectations and answer God's call with joy.
Thank you.
Our story within the story, long, short, narrative or fables, and creation stories, the story continues. Poetry, sonnets, the quest, the voyage, and return to faith, the story continues. Past, present, and future events yet to be experienced in hope, the story continues. In births, rebirth, baptism, and in tragedy, the story continues. In someone's life or in the evolution of time, have all our stories already been told? The story continues in the Christ child. God's story continues. We remember.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness God called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day.
In a fractured age, when cynicism is God, here is a possible heresy. We live by stories. We also live in them. One way or another, we are living the stories planted in us early or along the way. We are also living the stories we planted, knowingly or unknowingly, in ourselves. We live the stories that either give our lives meaning or negate it with meaninglessness. If we change the stories we live by, quite possibly we change our lives.
Augsburg's spirit is propelled by a heartbeat that started long before us. That heartbeat was present before our founding, when the land where Augsburg University and Central Lutheran today stand was stewarded by the Dakota people. The Dakota are the original inhabitants of this area, and they are still here today. We honor their wisdom about this place, their recognition that we are all part of the same creation. We share their sense of obligation to the larger community, including to future generations.
Oh.
Because the stakes are so high, even though you're up to date on all this truth and practice it inside and out, I'm not going to let up for a minute in calling you to attention before it. This is the post to which I have been assigned, keeping you alert with frequent reminders, and I'm sticking to it as long as I live.
Jesus is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in Christ were created all things in heaven and on earth, everything visible and invisible, thrones, dominions, sovereignties, powers. All things have been created through Christ and for Christ. Before anything was created, Christ existed, and all things hold together in Christ. The church is the body. Christ is its head. Christ is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, and so Christ is first in every way. God wanted all perfection to be found in Christ, and all things to be reconciled to God through Christ.
He did not wait till the world was ready, till men and nations were at peace. He came when the heavens were unsteady and prisoners cried out for release.
He did not wait for the perfect time. He came when the need was deep and great. He dined with sinners in all their grime, turned water into wine.
He did not wait till hearts were pure. In joy he came to a tarnished world of sin and doubt, to a world like ours of anguish, shame. He came, and his light would not go out.
He came to a world which did not mesh, to heal its tangles, shield its scorn. In the mystery of the Word made flesh, the Maker of the stars was born.
We cannot wait till the world is sane
to raise our songs with joyful voice, for to share our grief, to touch our pain. He came with love. Rejoice, rejoice.
Thank you.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us."
So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Thank you.
This story we remember. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
You are raw with heaven. So we mortals lean in to fill our senses with your mystery and promises. You were not here, and then suddenly you were, and now we cannot recall anything else. This is deep time love. Holding you exposes a whole universe of trouble, already blessing the world. You are turning us around to see the grace we forgot keeps and fills all of us with brave and gentle love. You are here, we are here, and God is right here. This changes everything.
Thank you.
Give praise to the Lord and call on God's name. Proclaim God's needs among the nations. Sing to God, sing praise. Tell of all God's marvels. Glory in God's holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Look to the Lord and God's strength. Seek God's presence always. Remember the marvels God has done, the wonders performed, and the judgments pronounced.
The joy of God has been through the poverty of the crib and the distress of the cross. Therefore, it is insuperable, irrefutable. It does not deny the distress where it is, but finds God in the midst of it, indeed precisely there. It does not contest the most grievous sin, but finds forgiveness in just this way. It looks death in the face, yet finds life in death itself. We are concerned with this joy which has overcome. It alone is worth believing. It alone helps and heals.
Thank you. todo lo que le hicieron fueron todos perdonados. Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, líbranos de todo mal y líbranos de las manos que nos quieren acabar.
Jesus didn't make it easy for himself by avoiding people's troubles, but waded right in and helped out. I took on the troubles of the troubled, is the way Scripture puts it. Even if it was written in Scripture long ago, you can be sure it's written for us. God wants the combination of his steady, constant calling and warm personal counsel in Scripture to come to characterize us, keeping us alert for whatever he will do next. May our dependably steady and warmly personal God develop maturity in you so that you get along with each other as well as Jesus gets along with us all. Then we'll be a choir, not our voices only, but our very lives singing in harmony in a stunning anthem to the God and Father of our Master Jesus.
Come, be among us, O Jesus. Come now and visit your people. Come and be near your children. Stay with us, Lord, abide. Shadows are deepening around us. Fast falls the eventide. Come and be near your children. Stay with us, Lord.
Thank you.
Whenever I am lost and forget who I am greeted with our friendship, tracing like a map, fingertip on fingerprints, pointing me to the recollection of memories, back to our first love, our purpose, where our purest intention is, the reason for our existence.
I find the outline of our fingerprints. While sitting, talking, eating lunch, I do this in remembrance for the times when I keep forgetting that, as we all forget, I am an extension of us.
Just you and me sipping coffee or tea, when gathered, something sacred stirs in the midst. In this moment, our presence is the truest gift. Since the beginning, what has sustained and strengthened us has always been in us.
No need to be siblings to share this sacred lineage. No need to look alike to bear a family resemblance. We're not forsaking the assembly of ourselves. We reassemble ourselves with each other's help.
We are all descendants ascending into this kinship. Whether shed or shared, no blood is as thick. When we reminisce, we revisit home, more alive and less alone.
Thank you.
love of the universe hovering over waters of creation, delighting in every living thing, calling us good. This is our story. Love incarnate, born to poor ones beneath a canopy of stars in the company of livestock, calling us to wonder. This is our story. Love remembered by our gathering, in our flesh and bones, beckoning us to heal a hurting world, calling us to dance. This is our story.
Beloveds, have you ever heard of anything like this? Has anything like this ever happened before, ever? Make sure you tell your children, and your children tell their children, and their children their children. Don't let this message die out.
Tonight we have heard the sacred story again, its truth, its power, its wisdom. This story continues to remake our world, birthing the reality of God's redeeming love into our hearts anew, remembering us into the family of God.
Go now, like Mary, carrying within you the story that God has implanted in this season, nurturing it with love and preparing to share it with the world. Go.